the real ones could vouch. They thought I was done, but all that doubt. You gotta play my new tricks around. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't here in my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Get salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy. I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me. I'm conceited. Treaty. Nah, that ain't how we treat it.
Welcome back in on EA Sports, and do not adjust your sets. That's our score, 27-7, a shocker thus far, and this has kind of turned into a classic trap game. And right now, this offense searching for answers as they try to mount a comeback from a three-touch. Fumble recovery. Madden eluding the pressure right.
Cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bum, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack. Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Check my name.
Welcome back in on EA Sports, and do not adjust your sets. That's our score, 27-7, a shocker thus far, and this has kind of turned into a classic trap game. And right now, this offense searching for answers as they try to mount a comeback from a three-touchdown deficit. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. That's to his running back, complete. And the Jets are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time, we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Bell is into the end zone for a Jets touchdown. Okay, Charles, so there you go. A much-needed score there to get this back to a two-score game.
And, Brandon, you and I both know from experience from talking with a number of guys who have played this game, when they're looking up at a scoreboard and seeing 27-7 against them, they're fighting with their team to combat the thinking, let's just get to the finish line and take our medicine. And this team, apparently, is fighting it. I think they firmly believe that they can win this game, and that's a big first step there.
After the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
Stevenson elects not to return it. It's a touchback.
Back onto the field now comes the Bills offense.
Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10.
On the counter, this is Singletary. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
Nice run defense presented there. And what I mean by that is discipline. Guys filling the right gaps in the right holes, no one over pursuing, and making a very nice play.
Still 9 remaining on second down.
Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen.
Trying for Sanders, but this is intercepted.
Marcus May with a pick, and he'll take this back down inside the 20.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot, and if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there, and sure enough, this one's going the other way.
On first down, Bell, and a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now Bell, only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there, and if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle, keep coming after them, put the pressure on them.
And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. A great play there. His second TD of the game and 16th on the season. And the Jets are able to make this a close game again.
So, CD, things starting to get a little more interesting. Another touchdown to cut the deficit further.
And remember, this was a 27-7 game at one point. So now momentum has totally changed. And I don't quite know why it took them so long to get it in gear. But obviously, they're not going to go down without a fight.
And keeping in mind how important any game is this time of year to their playoff seeding, it's a game they can't really afford to lose.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
Stevenson elects not to return it. It's a touchback. The Bills ready to take over.
Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw.
And Allen going to be intercepted for the third time.
Picked off by Mikel Roby Coleman. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
Well, a first down and then some. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. 149 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
He was doing everything he could to get the 6 points, a little bit short, but still an excellent run.
And look at it from the defense's point of view. They could have given up on that play. They did not, and still were able to corral him. Now, they've got some work to do on this down coming up, but at least they're being competitive and trying to.
Now he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Le'Veon Bell. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets can take the lead now with the extra point. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. And with that, his guys take the lead here by a point. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. 2 plays later, pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Stevenson elects not to return it. It's a touchback. Here comes Josh Allen and the Bills offense back onto the field.
He has to sort of pick himself up off the mat now, Charles. They were winning at halftime, now losing it. He's not playing well.
Sometimes you get into a position where you get a little bit too greedy. You feel great about how you're playing. Good first half. Hey, I can do even more in the second half. And then you make throws that you're not supposed to. As you said, he's got to start to turn things around.
See if he can erase those 2 third-quarter interceptions from his mind.
On play action, Allen. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A big gain there for the Bills. Offense just continues to reign supreme. Big plays, both sides back and forth. Tough to keep track of.
It certainly is, and I'm over here just marveling at what I'm seeing. It's tough for you, though. You've got to call all these big plays and have all this emotion each time they go at each other.
And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. He pushes forward for maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Here's Allen. Gonna go down, sacked back at the 13-yard line. And not a good time for the sack on second and goal, a loss of 6, and now it's third down. Now Allen works right side into the hands of the tight end, Knox. They do get 8 out of the pitch and catch, however, it's fourth down.
All right, field goal gets you the lead here. I mean, but I might want to just go ahead and go for something big.
Oh, come on, you got to kick it.
I mean, you got to be glad I'm not the head coach here, right? The whole team would want to revolt at this point.
So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game.
They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be 3rd and about a foot or 2.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker.
They'll go again with Bell.
And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. 162 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. On second down, it's Bell. And he's taken down inside the 30.
Definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
On the move to his left. A solid stiff arm. And he's brought down after a very nice game.
Nothing here.
The question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Carter will take this one in. Touchdown, New York. So what a comeback here, Charles. Down 3 touchdowns in the second half. They've surged back to take the lead.
And I attribute this squarely to the veteran leaders on this team because they know how important a game this is. And after this one's over, I think the media is going to be in the locker room. Yeah, maybe we took these guys a little bit too lightly early on, but they've been completely transformed here in the second half, and they may just come out of here with a victory.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Here comes Marquez Stevenson now from his end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
We dominate today!
Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. It won't be a sack, but it's no gain, and it brings up second down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
Meanwhile, Allen's throw caught by Sanders. The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. From the gun, it's Allen. And he completes it to the tight end, Knox. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Now on first down. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance. From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Allen's throw is complete. That'll leave him with a 3rd and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary, and I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket. You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Allen. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They move the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be.
And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line. C.J. Mosley. in there to record another sack, and that is now six on the afternoon for this defensive unit. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. Back to throw. Allen. On the left side, he finds Beasley. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal. Looking to throw. Allen steps away to his left, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Josh Allen, a 10-yard touchdown run, and the Bills have retaken the lead.
A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. Allen will try to throw for it. Forced out to his left. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. So that effort gives him a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy, because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage, at least give your team a fighting chance.
And Davis content just to bring this out to the 25-yard line. Le'Veon Bell and the Jets ready to begin their next drive. He has a chance to hit that often elusive 200-yard mark on this drive.
And most of the time during a game, people aren't keeping track of individual statistics.
Are you sure?
Yeah, a lot of the runners kind of know. But I'll guarantee you, someone has sent word into the offensive line that he's got a chance to get over 200 on this drive. That should give them a little extra motivation, because they love it when backs break that barrier.
Absolutely. See if he can do it. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Back to throw. Madden. He'll check this one down to Carter. Calling a gain of six on the play, and that'll bring up second down. Territory just across midfield at the 49.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 49-yard line. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. Here's the tight end. This is Landry. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Operating from the gun, Madden. That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Oh, a pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least, it'll be fourth down. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's got Herndon, his tight end. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays have been successful throughout the game that have worked in the distance you need. And that's exactly what they got done.
On first and 10, it's Carter. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and 6.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive
take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
Off the bootleg, Madden. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. A field goal try would be almost 50 yards from this spot, so what can they do to get closer now on third down? Flush to his right. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. 60 yards on the ground for him so far.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Working with a second and 4. Carter once more. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Now the Jets going to use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Here's a give to Carter. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Michael Carter with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets have once again taken the lead.
And touchdown and congratulations and zero relaxation ahead of them, right? Way too much time on the clock for them to start celebrating.
Yeah, part one is done, but now on the sideline, you can already see them scrambling down there. They're getting those defensive guys ready.
Yes, you have to get those guys ready, and you also have to talk to your special teams guys. Make sure the kickoff is exactly what you want and cover it well.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that will make this a 4-point game. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it was capped off by the rookie Michael Carter's touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Stevenson elects not to return it. It's a touchback. Allen and the Bills now. Down by 4, 1:09 to play. Their losing streak in danger of continuing as they come up on first down. Allen. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Force the ball free and it's second down. Throwing is Allen. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions now, 3rd and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. One final try here for Allen. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Marcus May with a pick. And he'll bring this one back to the 29. When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that, because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead, they found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game.
They'll run. It's Carter.
And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout, as he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and seven.
A handoff for Carter.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Gonzalez good on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. So they only needed three plays on that drive.
And it was capped off by the rookie Michael Carter's touchdown run.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away.
This fielded right at the goal line. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Now Allen. He'll be taken down. The Jets get in there for the sack. Allen. Into the hands of Singletary. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Jets, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year. And they'll have another home date next week as the Miami Dolphins come to town. Meanwhile, for the Bills, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Indianapolis Colts. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Bottom line, we didn't deserve to win that game. We'll take it, but we can't afford to have another first half that bad again.
The biggest story coming out of last week's games was the incredible comeback we saw. 20 points down at